Hello again, everyone. I want to welcome all my students and students that are not my students and wish everyone the best on the EOC on the 9th and 10th of May. Let's take a look here. There are some properties of circles that you must memorize to work, at least this worksheet. So let's take a look here. You have 7 of them, and I want you to draw these, and I want you to memorize them, so make sure you study. This one is in the center of the circle, so this is called a central angle. So the angle and the arc are the same. So if this is 30 degrees, then this would be 30 degrees, okay? This is your arc from here to here, all right? Now, number 2 is called an inscribed circle because the vertex is on the circle. So the angle is half of the intercepted arc. So if this arc is 60, then this angle is 30. If the angle is 30, then the arc is 60. Number 3, the vertex is outside the circle, like this. Okay? This one, the angle is equal to half of the difference. So the angle A is equal to half of the difference of B minus C. So angle A is equal to half of the big arc, which is B, minus the little arc, which is C. And there's the formula right there. And there's another one also. We might as well go ahead. It's a little out of order maybe from what I originally taught you, but it might be good here. Okay? So this piece, A, B, C, D. So the outside piece, A, times the whole thing, which is A plus B, is equal to the outside piece, which is C, times the whole thing, which is C plus D. Okay, so these two kind of go together because the vertex is on the outside. Now, number 5, the angle is on the inside, but not the center of the circle. So if this is A, B, and C, then the angle, and by the way, these angles are equal because they're vertical. So angle A on this one is equal to half of the sum of arc B plus C. And it doesn't matter on this one which one you go first, B plus C or C plus B. But when you subtract, oh yeah, it does matter. It's the big arc minus the little arc. Number 6, okay? Number 6 is the product. And it looks similar to this one here, okay? It's where you have a A, B, a C, and a D, and you follow this line. So these two go together. So it's going to be A times B equals C times D. And again, this is not the order that I originally taught you, but that's okay. And number 7 is a tangent, where you have A, B, and C. So it's tangent squared because it hits the circle at one point. So it's A squared is equal to the outside, which is B, times the whole thing, which is B plus C. And you can see this one is similar to this one up here. Okay, it's similar, but instead of having 2 of them like this, you have 1 of them that's a tangent. Okay, so that's all 7 formulas. And when you walk in on next Thursday and Friday, you have to have those formulas memorized, okay? So let's take a look here at today's work. All right, well, this one right here, I wanted you to find, it says the measure of angle C is 55 degrees. Find the measure of angle D. What you need to know here is this angle right here has a vertex on the circle, so this arc is 110. You have to double it. That's called an inscribed angle, by the way. And this angle D hits the same arc. So since it hits the same arc, this one is the same measure, which is 55 degrees. They are equal. Okay? The next one, let's see what's going on here. We have 2 tangents, and I kind of read a little bit a little while ago. And it says, if any triangle, if given any triangle STR, with these conditions, which statements must be true? Right, we've got to go through these. Side TR could pass through point Q. Interesting question. I don't know. That's a possibility. Okay, let me look at the rest of them. Angle S is always smaller than those two angles, angle T and angle R? That's another good question there. Okay, let's keep going. Triangle STR is always an isosceles. That is a definite true, okay? This piece, tangent, is equal to that piece. Tangents from the same point are equal, and that's the one I would go with, okay? All right, let's go on. In this circle, and by the way, let's say this circle right here had a P here, and they wanted you to name that circle, you would say circle P. Okay, make sure you understand that, okay? The measure of QR is 72 degrees. So QR is an arc. And they should have put a little arc sign on there because that kind of messed me up a little bit. So QR is 72 degrees. Okay. What's the measure of QPR? So QPR is this angle. It's an inscribed angle, so it's half of that, which I guess is 36, is it? And I think it's 36. Okay. 6 and 6 is 12, and I think that's right. All right, let's go on. On the next one here, you should have your packet by now. So go ahead and work this problem right here. Well, let's take a look here. What is wrong with the information given in a diagram? Okay, well, let's see. Let me think about this. The information given. Okay, well, first of all, let's just work this arc right here. Let's see what happens. This angle is in the circle but not the center. So 88 is equal to half of the sum of 118 plus x. Okay, we're going to solve that equation and see what happens. We're going to multiply this one by 2 to get rid of this 2 here. So we're going to have 118 plus x here, and 2 times 88. So 2 times 88 is going to give us 176. And then we're going to subtract 118. So minus 118. And when we do that, we get 58 degrees. So this angle is 58 degrees according to what I just did. Now, this one right here, this angle here, is an inscribed angle, and it hits that arc. So twice that is 70 degrees according to the information. So something's wrong here, okay? So let's see which one we can pick out. Segment HJ should pass through the center of the circle. HJ should pass through the center. I don't know, maybe. The length of GH should be equal to the length of JK. The length of GH, this length here, should be equal to that length there. That's a good question. I don't think so because the angles are different. The measure of angle GHM, okay, let's see, GHM, okay, let's see, angle GHM, this angle right here, this angle should be equal to the measure of angle JKM, this angle. I guess that's possible. The measure of angle HMK, let's see, HMK, this angle right here, should be equal to half of the measure of angle H, measure of HK. HK is here. Okay. No, it shouldn't be half. It's not an inscribed. The problem here is, you know, I did the formula, and this one came to 58, and then I did this one double, and I got 70. So somewhere up in here will be the answer. I'm just not seeing it, but there is a definite problem. So I'm going to put a little mark by this one, and we can always come back to it. All right, let's take a look at this next one. Try this one. And maybe while I'm working this problem in class, we can figure it out, okay? So look, see, cards WP, which is this chord here, okay, intersects KZ at point L. Okay, we got that. What's the length of KZ? So let's see, find KZ. KZ is this whole thing. So they want this whole thing here, okay? And the whole thing would be 2 plus 3x minus 2, just so you know. So we have to find x. We're going to use the product rule on this. So it's this times this. So x times 5 is equal to 2 times that. So 2 times 3x minus 2. So we're going to get 5x is equal to, we're going to distribute, so that's 6x minus 4. Make sure you do both of these, okay? We want to distribute properly. We want to subtract 5x, so we're going to get x equals, move that 4 over here. We get x equals 4, but they don't want to know x, so we're going to substitute a 4 right here. 3 times 4 is 12, so it's going to be 2 plus 12 minus 2. The 2's cancel. I get 12, and that's the one I'm going to go with, and there it is. Okay, try this one here. Okay, I'll make it a little larger for those of you at home. Okay, well, let's see what's going on here. In circle 0, okay, circle O, so circle O, angle SOT, SOT, this one, is equal to 68 degrees. This is a central angle here, okay? So that means this arc is equal to the angle. And this angle, which is the one I think they want, SRT, is half of 68. So half of 6 is 3, half of that's 4, so I'm going to say 34 degrees. Is that angle. Okay? So we went from a central angle to an inscribed angle. And they both intercept the same arc. Okay? Now let's go on. We have a tangent here. Let's see what's going on here. In circle P, okay, again, that's how you name it. Circle P has these tangents. So this one is tangent to that one. And in the chords, these chords right here, I guess they're talking about WZ and WX, as shown. The measure of angle ZWX, so ZWX, this angle right here, is equal to 70 degrees. That's an inscribed angle because the vertex is there. So this one's 140 degrees, okay? Now the question is, what's the measure of angle XYZ? XYZ, they want to know this one. So put an X right there. Now here's how you do this one. Okay. If you understood that, you know that every circle is 360. So we're going to subtract 140 and get 220. So from here to here, this arc is 220 degrees. Write that on your paper, okay? Since this angle is on the outside, the angle is equal to half of the big arc, which is 220, minus the little arc, which is 140. And this is going to work, okay? So this right here, 60, 70, 80, I think that's 80 divided by 2. I'm going with 40. And that should be it, okay? All right, so the trick here is you have an inscribed angle, you got to double it. This vertex is on the outside, and it's going to be half of the big arc minus the little arc. So since you have the little arc, you subtract from 360 to get the big arc, and then you do big arc minus little arc divided by 2. All right, so I just reviewed that one with you a few times. Let's go on. All right, on the back side here, let's take a look and see what's going on. All right, they give you some information, so let's see what they want. The center of the inscribed circle of a triangle has been established. Okay, the center of the inscribed angle. So inscribed angle. So here's your center, and there's an inscribed angle. Okay, which point on one of the sides of the triangle should be chosen to set the width of the compass? Okay, I'm not sure that we did one like this. Okay, so I'm going to throw my hands up on this one because we didn't do one like that. Okay, so for the time being, we'll put a little question mark. All right, move on. This one right here, let's take a look. Angle A is 85. Angle D is 80. In quadrilateral, it's inscribed in a circle below. Find the measure of angle B. So they want this angle right here. Let's take a look. All right, let's think about this a minute. Okay. These two are not equal, so the lines are not parallel. So this is an inscribed angle. So this arc from here to here is equal to twice that. So 2 times 85. Let's just see if we're going in the right direction. So that arc is 170 degrees, okay? By the same token, this angle, this arc hits from here to here, and we got to double that, so that's 160 degrees, okay? And we're looking for angle B. So let me think here. All right, so we could subtract that and get 10. on that one. So let's think. Okay, we have an overlap here. They overlap at arc BC right there. So that should be 10 degrees is what I'm thinking when you subtract these two. But let me see how that's going to help us. They want angle B here. Okay, so angle B intersects this arc from here all the way to here. Okay, that's where angle B, it hits here and it hits there. Okay, so what we need to kind of do is figure out what that big arc is. Okay, so I'm not seeing it readily. Okay, so we're going to punt on this one as well. But somewhere up in here with these arcs is going to be your answer. So I want you to think about that one a little bit more. Some of these are hypothetical questions. So I'm going to get past that. And we'll do one more here. Try to work this one out. Okay, so try that one. Let's put some information on there. It says AF is 6. So AF is 6. So put a 6 from here to here. Okay. And CD is 5. So CD is from here to here. So put a 5 right there. Okay. And BE, which is this one, BE is 4. Okay. So what you have here, I think I know what they're doing. We did have one like this. This right here is a tangent from the same point B, and that's a tangent, so this one's equal. This one's a tangent and a tangent, so these two are equal. This one is tangent, and that one's tangent from the same point, so that one's 5. So to get perimeter, you just add them up. 6 and 6 is 12. We could do 10 there and 10 there and 10 there. So 10, 20, 30, that should be your answer right there. All right, finally, on the back side, we definitely did have all of this. Try this top one. This one right here is the area of the shaded sector, so that's area of sector. An area of sector is equal to a fraction times pi radius squared, okay? So the fraction here, if this is 135 degrees and the whole thing is 360, the whole circle, so we're going to subtract 135 from 360. So 360 minus 135, press equals. So this one is 225 degrees on the shaded side. So that's going to be our fraction. So put 225 over 360, which is the whole circle, that's your fraction, times pi, 3.14, times the radius squared. The radius is 8. So it's 8 times 8. That definitely will work, okay? So we're going to wrap this up in just a moment. Let's see what's going on. 225 times 3.14 times 64, which is 8 times 8, and then divide it by 360, and I get 125.6. So 125.6, and they left it in terms of pi. So let me back out of that. Take 225 times 64, press equals, divide by 360, and I get 40. So it's going to be 40 pi, which would be that one. Okay, so it's the same difference. If you multiply 40 times 3.14, you will get that. All right, this one is what's the area of the sector of the 90 degrees? So they want area again. So it's a quarter of the whole circle. So basically, you could do pi radius squared divided by 4. Okay. But if you don't want to do that, you could take 90 over 360 times pi. They're leaving it as pi, the radius squared. The radius is, I guess, 3 inches. So it's going to be 9, 3 times 3, 9 times 90. So 9 times 90, press equals, and then divide by 4, or divide by 360, rather, sorry. Divide it by 360, and I get 2.25 pi, so that's 2 1/4. So which one is 2 1/4 here? I think it's this one right here, okay? 9 divided by 4, let's try that. 9 divided by 4 should be my answer, and it is. Okay, let me get that light back on. All right, we're back on business here, and stay with me. We're almost done. It looks like my focus is staying on today. I'm gonna get rid of that autofocus just in case, okay? All right, so I guess the next one is the same way. Find the area of the sector, area of the sector. They're all the same. So this is 120 over 360 times pi radius squared. This one is gonna be 270, I think, over 360, because you want the shaded region, probably, and you do. And then times pi radius squared, okay? But you do need to know arc length, okay? So what I want you to do is find out how long this piece is from here to here. This is just a little add-on problem. So that whole thing is 270 degrees, okay? So 270 divided by 360 times pi times diameter, okay? Let's see, the diameter is 10. So if the diameter is 10, that's going to be 5 and 5. So you're going to have 270 times pi times the diameter, which is 10, divided by 360, and that gives you this arc length. Okay? And that takes care of that, and that's your review. And you can try to work on some of those other ones. So have a good morning.